Hey guys, it's Haff. I am back again and I am going to do a haul video for you today. I went into the city the other day with my daughter and I bought some stuff. So I thought I'd do a little haul video, and I've also got some things from Born Pretty that just arrived that I will be doing reviews on, so I thought I would show them to you before I do the reviews. So let's get into it. So first of all, from Born Pretty, I have a UV gel polish. This is in Starry Sky, so it's like in blue. It's a blue kind of color. And then I have this Flower Fairy gel, which is actually gel, like a clear gel with little tiny flowers in it, which I thought was interesting, especially with the whole milk bath thing going on at the moment in the nail world. I thought this would be interesting to try out. And I also got another stamping plate. Yes, I have a lot of stamping plates. I like stamping plates. They're fun. And this one actually has marbled patterns on it to do kind of like fake marble and stone. So I thought that would be interesting. So keep an eye out for reviews on those items, which I will be doing shortly on my channel. So let's get on to the stuff I bought. Most of it I bought at Priceline. Priceline had their 50% off or 40% off, I think it was 50% off, cosmetic sale on most of their cosmetics on the day that I was in the city. They do it for two or three times a year for like 3 days or whatever. So most of the stuff is from there. But in, I think that one was, Target Australia, they sell the balm. You can get some balm stuff in Priceline, but they did not have the one thing I've been looking for a while, which is the What's Your Type mascara. John McLean uses his favourite mascara, and he uses it in all of his videos, and his like mascara always looks really good, and I've been really, really, really wanting to try it, and it's been really hard to get. It's not the cheapest to buy the balm in Australia, so this was not exactly cheap, but yeah, that's been looking forward to trying this one out, so I bought that one. And they had this Napoleon Purtis trio of glosses. Now the, it's supposed to be, like, these are $30 each if you buy them individually. This kit, this pack, was supposed to be $35, but because I bought it while they had a sale, and I believe it was 30% off, or 40% off Napoleon Purtis, which doesn't often go on sale, this was only $17.50. So these were only just over $5 each, which I'm prepared to pay. Some of Napoleon Purtis' stuff is really good, but most of it's just completely overpriced. So, and like the packaging is a little excessive for, I mean the box seems quite nice, but excessive packaging. So there are these three lip glosses. There's one in My Work, which looks like a fairly clear gloss. With some pink in it. And then we have My Dear, which appears to be that would just add a little bit of pink to your lips. And the last one is My Art, which is this kind of tealy coloured one, which is honestly what made me buy it. Yeah, they smell nice. they smell nice. Okay, I bought an Australis makeup setting mist. This is actually one of my favourite makeup setting mists. I don't know if it sets my makeup, but I like the way it smells. And this is probably about the fourth bottle of this that I've actually bought. On the setting spray line, I also picked up a NYX Dewy Finish. I've tried their matte one. I don't like it. I don't actually like the smell. I'm sure this one smells the same, but I prefer a dewy finish to a matte finish. Actually, I don't have any setting spray on at the moment. Yeah, I still don't really like the smell, but yeah. So I bought that. It wasn't exactly cheap. It was like $11, which is cheaper than it could have been. I'm just gonna do this out of the bag before I make any more noise. You can hear all the nail polish. Yep. Should have known there'd be nail polish. It's me. Okay, so I picked up a NYX Can't Stop, Won't Stop concealer. I walked through, this is the thing I do in Priceline, I walk around and I use all the testers of concealer or foundation to find the right shade. Like I wander around, I usually put it on the back of my hand, and I wander around for a while, and I see which one sets and which colour looks best and which one doesn't look too yellow, because yellow under my eyes is the thing I hate. So which one doesn't look too yellow, which one doesn't look too pink, and which one is light enough. And I think I've had about 8 or 9 swatches on the back of my hand, and this was the only one that did not look too yellow or too pink or too dark, and that is the pale one of the NYX one, which is only just not white. It's like maybe 2 steps up from white. Yeah, so I picked that up because I want to find other choices for concealer. I also picked up another one of these metallics eyeshadows. This from Australis. This one is in Silver Club 7. All of these have got the name of bands. So like S Club 7. The one that I used the other day was Guns N' Rose Petals. So for Guns N' Roses. And I have, I think it's Lana Del Grey. But I really enjoyed how this looked. Like I did a, it was in my last makeup basket when I put like the, this, I think it was the Guns N' Roses Petal one on my eyes. I really liked how it looked, so I thought I'm going to get another one because I liked how it looked. So this one is silver. You basically just need to like pack it on with your finger. But it looked really good on, and I thought, I want to try another one. So yeah, I bought that one. And then I bought these 2 eyeshadows from Revlon. I hadn't heard of them. They're called the Liquid Alloy eyeshadows. They have them in 4 different shades. I swatched all 4 of them, and these were the 2 that I decided I wanted. One of them is purple and the other one is not. Let me just cut the tape that is. Okay. So the purple one is Bruges Brew. And these are gorgeous. And they dry down. And I know they dry down because everything else smeared on the back of my hand, and then when I rubbed it all off, everything else came off except for these. I had them on my hands for like 12 hours. And the other one is Wicked Potion. Which is a silvery grey. but it has basically holographic glitters in it. But they do dry down and they're so gorgeous. Just, they look so pretty. Can't really tell in this light, but they're super pretty. And then I bought some nail polish. So, Model Zone is, not Model Co, which was in my last video, but Model Zone is in receivership. And so a lot of this stuff is going out super duper cheap. Hang on a second, I think this one's dried out and I didn't realise. To see if I can salvage that one. I picked up a couple of their nail polishes. This one is like, they were like $1.50 each. Yeah, the girl who sold it to me, I saw her put the lid back on it. She should have double checked it to make sure it was actually saleable. Has put some nail polish thinner. Yes, I have nail polish thinner on the table right in front. So that one is chrome copper, and the other one I got is chrome gold. So this one hopefully is okay. Yep, that one's okay. So I picked up those two because they're like, as I said, like $1.50 each. So. I picked up two of the, I literally have silver everywhere, picked up two of the Sinful Colours Naughty Nudes, which are in colours that are not nude. So the first one is called Nude Mood, which is funny because it looks purple to me. I'm just going to paint it on my finger now. Oops, I've got to wipe my skin. Wow. This is not how I normally paint my nails, by the way. So, this is nude. Sorry, didn't mean to give me the... This is Nude Mood. Dark purple. But it has this really interesting goldy kind of shade. Which I don't know if you're going to be able to see. Camera doesn't want to focus. There we go. See, it's got that kind of weird gold shimmer in it. Which I thought was really interesting. And the other one is Skintillating. So even if they meant nude as in skin toned, which then, you know, the purple one might almost make sense, this one doesn't fit that at all because nobody is this colour. So I'm not really quite sure what they're... what they were trying to achieve with this particular collection. I just got it everywhere. So this is one of my pointer finger is Skintillating. They both look very, very dark. This is actually green to purple. Again, I don't know if it's going to show. But it's actually a green to purple shift. And nobody's skin is green to purple, so yeah. I'm not quite sure how those two ended up in the naughty nudes, because they're not nude. And then I picked up two more from the Essence Cosmic Lights line, because I didn't have either of these two. I had three other ones, but I'd never seen the other ones in the store. So this one is the silver. This is Welcome to the Universe. So it is a silver with holographic glitter in it. Super pretty. They're kind of like a chrome base, so they're chrome with holo. I love chrome, I love holo. And the other one is the dark grey, blue-grey type colour called Up in the Sky. So I will just, for shits and giggles, I'll paint them on the other two nails that I have sitting here. Yeah, it comes out a lot more blue on the nail. Probably needs two coats, but... So, that one is Up in the Sky. And... we have a Welcome to the Universe. That one definitely would need a second coat. It's still super pretty. And that one is a Welcome to the Universe. So those are the four nail polishes that I picked up, plus these two here. Which for me is not really buying very much nail polish at all. I also picked up the Miracle Gel Matte Top Coat. This is actually pretty new. Well, it's new in Australia. It's not really gel, it's gel-like, which is not the same thing. If you don't have to cure it under a light, it's not gel, it's gel-like. And what they're referring to is that gel tends to have a very shiny kind of look to it, and kind of almost like a plump look to it, which normal polish generally doesn't have. So when they're talking about it being gel-like, they're just saying that it's more like shiny or glossy or plump looking on the nail. So I'm just going to show you. I'm curious as to whether this is a very good matte top coat. There are good matte top coats and then there are not good matte top coats. So I'm literally going to put it over the top of Skintillating. Which dried pretty shiny. Matte top coats also dry really, really fast. To a point, like they start to look matte really fast. But they're not really dry really fast, and they can take quite a long time to dry completely. So you've got to be like super duper careful. And they chip more. So you're actually better off putting a quick dry top coat on first and then putting a matte top coat on top of that, and then it'll last for longer than just putting on a matte top coat. So you can actually see, look at those two together, that it's, yeah, it's reasonably matte. Matte always makes shimmers look so interesting. So not a bad matte top coat. So those are all of the makeup-y type things that I bought whilst I was shopping with my daughter the other day. If you want to subscribe, click the little bell down there. Click the button down there. And then click the little bell if you want to get notified of when I upload new content. Sometimes you have to like click it and then click it again so that it opens up the things that you can like mark whether you want all notifications or just some notifications. It's a thing. Leave me a thumbs up if you like whole type videos, and leave me a comment down below. I try to respond to all comments, and I'll see you in my next video.